During the 5th Annual National Health Financing Conference, stakeholders have expressed concern on the unstable budget allocations to the health sector, despite the fact that it is pivotal in the country's development.
We have seen a slight upward trend. Look, considering the national budget for financial year 2023-2024, in comparison to the previous one, 2022-2023, there is a slight upward trend, but when it comes to the sub-programs, where health falls, it is called population health, safety and management.
Subsequently, these have presented a number of concerns which have equally affected people through incurring out-pocket expenses whenever calamities fall.
The essential healthcare package is still underfunded, or largely funded by donors at about 42%. And you highlighted rightly, Ms. Happy, that the out-of-pocket payments is also at a high at about 41%. This creates issues for both equity and sustainability. And I know that all through COVID, we all had a chance to test what that means, not with our own selves alone, but also with our families and relatives.
The Advocacy Program Coordinator at the Center for Health, Human Rights and Development, Peter Echeru, noted that over time, one challenge has led to another, thus needing to pay close attention to the lowest of programs in the sector.
We move to the next facility. Remember, we are supposed to have a referral pathway for our health delivery system. But because of absence of drugs in the health system, you have distorted the whole referral pathway.
Themed on deepening and exploring innovative approaches to domestic health financing in Uganda, these strongly believe that if their voices are heard and adhered to, it will be a clear ticket to forgetting such catastrophes.
So currently, we are thinking at this conference, we are exploring any innovative approaches for domestic healthcare financing so that we have alternatives that can leverage or can cushion the citizen from spending too much. I know we have our community groups, barrio groups, support groups, we collect money, we have circles. Can we use this money for purposes of treatment, not even waiting to buy a coffee?
The woman member of parliament for Terego District, Rose Obiga, has given confidence to the participants in the conference and the country at large to stage a resilient force towards ensuring the national health policy turns into law.
There is hope, and a very big hope for the health, for the national health insurance policy and law. Reasons: anybody who is sick out there has the member of parliament of the area as his or her only next step. And now we're spending so much on health, and now the 11th parliament has seen that there is a reason to have this passed.
As advocacy for innovative approaches takes center stage, it should be known that less than 1% of Ugandans have private health insurance, according to the Uganda Insurance Regulatory Authority. Despite the high levels of poverty coupled with 10% inflation, 42% of health expenditure is out of the pockets of citizens. Contingent reliance on donors is generally unsustainable and unpredictable. Thus, such discussions are quite necessary at the time, on a verge to bring forth everlasting solutions in the light of domestic health financing in Uganda. Report compiled by Derrick Asaba for the news.